Hi everybody. In this video, I'll be discussing about the answer for a 15 marks requirement on exchange rate requirements, exchange rate risk management, exchange rate hedging. This is the company details. This was a 50 marks question in this paper, June 2014 paper. Let me summarize what is there out of all these details. A payment of $5,060,000 is due in 4 months' time. First part of this question, part A of this question, is about hedging the exchange rate fluctuation risk on this payment. If you go further reading this question, the information they have given, current spot rate is given, US dollar per franc, currency futures are given. Currency options are given, and here forward rate is given. Read the requirement. Advise CMC company on appropriate hedging strategy to manage the foreign exchange exposure of the US dollar payment in the 4 months' time. Show all relevant calculations, including the number of contracts bought or sold in the exchange traded derivative after 15 marks. We'll see how to answer questions like this. This is a typical type of question on exchange rate risk management. See how we answer. This company has three options or three methods of hedging exchange rate risk. This company has three methods of hedging exchange rate risk. One, forward contracts. Two, currency futures. Three, currency options. But we'll take one by one now. Forward contracts. Forward contract answers are usually straightforward. They have given you the forward rate. What's the forward rate? $1.0677 per franc. The amount to be hedged is $5,060,000. Forward rate 1.0677 dollar per franc. So net cost to the company $5,060 divided by the forward rate. That, what is that currency? Francs. That's very straightforward. You take the transaction amount, apply the forward rate, and find the net cost. Second one is going to be currency options. Sorry, currency futures. See the steps in answering currency futures. You have to follow all these steps step by step. Contract currency is francs. What do I mean by contract currency is francs? Go back and see the details they have given about futures. Futures contract size is Swiss francs, 125,000. So size is given in francs. This is what we call contract currency. Contract currency is francs. Now I need to decide whether this company wants to sell francs or buy francs. See, this is a Switzerland company. They have a supplier in US to whom they have to pay in dollars. After 4 months, they have to pay in dollars. Do they have dollars with them? No. So they have to buy dollars. Have to buy dollars. Company has to buy dollars. But that statement doesn't matter to me. I have to speak in terms of francs because contract currency is francs. So has to buy dollars means how do they buy dollars? By selling francs. They give francs and buy dollars. So continue. I can continue writing. Company has to buy dollars, selling francs. That's what is important to me. Selling francs is important. Why? Contract currency is francs. So since it is selling francs, company has the need to sell francs. Sell futures initially to open its position in futures. Sell futures initially. This is what step one in currency futures working. Identifying whether company wants to sell futures initially or buy futures initially. Then you identify which expiry it has to choose. There are two expiry dates of futures is given to you. 3 month expiry, 6 month expiry. Remember the transaction, the settlement is going to happen in 4 months from now. So if you select the 3 month futures before your settlement date, the future is going to expire. So on the settlement day, the 3 month expiry future wouldn't be helpful. So what do I select? This is the rule. Select the first one that expires, after the settlement date. Your settlement date is 4 months. So after 4 months, only 6 month expiry futures is available. So select 6 month expiry, 6 month expiry futures will be selected. Right. Then you calculate number of contracts. To calculate number of contracts, first thing I have to do the transaction amount to be hedged that is given in dollars. See, number of contract formula is this. Number of contract is amount to be hedged divided by contract size. Problem here, amount to be hedged is in dollars, contract size is in francs, 125,000 francs, you can just divide them. So first thing I'm going to do, amount to be hedged 5,060,000, this figure, let me convert into francs using what rate? Using opening futures price, you are supposed to convert this. What is opening futures price? I selected 6 month expiry, 1.0659 is the opening futures price. 1.0659. By dividing so, I'll get the amount to be hedged in francs itself. Now the contract size is also in francs. I can find the number of contracts. Number of contracts has to be this answer divided by contract size. What is the contract size? 125,000 francs. 38 contracts are required. Right. Now we'll come to the calculations. Final calculations in futures. What are the final calculations? What is going to be the net cost to the company? To find the net cost to the company, there are two methods. One method is finding spot trade transaction separately, finding futures gain or loss separately, adding them together. I repeat, just spot rate conversion of the amount is one value. Futures trading gain or loss could be there, which is another value. Adding both values, you can find the net outcome, which is one method. The other method is getting the lock-in rate, applying the lock-in rate directly on the hedged amount, transaction amount. You get the answer directly, which could be easier method, which is what commonly we use in the exams, lock-in rate. How do you find lock-in rate? This is the table we use for it. take the dates today. Now, after 4 months, what is after 4 months? That is when the settlement happens. That is when I need this currency. After 6 months, why after 6 months? That is when this futures expires. I have selected 6 month expiry. Done. Take the spot rate. Take the futures price. The difference is what you call basis. Spot minus futures is basis. What's the spot today? What's the spot today? It's given 1.0635. What is futures price? The selected future 6 month expiry 1.0659. Why is it showing like this? Right. So the basis is going to be spot minus futures price. So which comes as a minus answer? 0024. Fine. Basis can be plus, basis can be minus. Don't be distracted by that. After 4 months, how do you find? Say when you had 6 months to expire, the basis was 24. Now you have only 2 more months to expire. So get it proportionately. This answer divided by 6 multiplied by 2. This is what you call unexpired basis on this date. How do we find the lock-in rate now? Lock-in rate is opening futures price plus unexpired basis. Opening futures price plus unexpired basis is the formula for lock-in rate. So lock-in rate is 1.0651. All these rates are given dollar per franc. Yeah. So the net cost to the company is going to be 5,060,000 is the amount to be hedged. 5,060,000 is the amount to be hedged. Effectively, this is what the rate is going to be. Why I say effectively is there will be some spot conversions, there will be some futures trading, there are going to be gain or loss on the futures trading. All put together, this is going to be the effective rate, locking rate. So net cost to the company is 4,750,728. I can compare this answer with that of forward contract. Forward contract gave me an answer of 4,739,000 something. This is 4,750. So relatively, forward contract is cheaper for this company. In my conclusion, I will highlight that. Done. So second method of hedging is over currency futures. Move on to third method of hedging now, which is currency options. Step one is always same, identifying whether you need a put option or a call option and which expiry. Contract currency is francs. Look at options again, it was given in francs, yes. Company needs to sell francs, therefore option to sell is needed, which means put option. Option to sell is called put option. Option to buy is known as buy option. So option to sell the francs is required, which is put option. Which put option you are going to choose? We'll see here. Put option, 3 month expiry, 6 month expiry. You have to choose 6 month expiry. I have already discussed the reason why. After 4 months only you have the settlement. So 3 month expiry wouldn't help you. 6 month expiry would help you. 6 month expiry. 6 month expiry is suitable. Right. Now there are two options. Option one, option two. Option two. What are the exercise prices? Option one exercise price is 1.06, other one is 1.07. 1.06. 1.06, 1.07. US dollar per franc. Exercise price quotation is dollar per franc. So say this is dollar per franc. Let me find in each case what's the number of contracts and let me sort out the premium, because when you're entering into option arrangements, first thing you have to pay premium. Whether you exercise it later, whether you lapse it later, doesn't matter. Premium has to be paid initially. Premium. To find premium, what you need? Number of contracts. Let's find the number of contracts. First, transaction amount or amount to be hedged. Amount to be hedged. Problem, amount to be hedged is in dollars. Convert that to francs using this exercise price. 5060,000 is the dollar amount of amount to be hedged divided by exercise price. That gives you the amount to be hedged in francs. Why am I doing this? Because contract size is given in franc, then only I can divide it and I can find the number of contracts. Do the same thing here. 5060 divided by exercise price. Right. So number of contract is going to be, number of contracts will be this figure divided by contract size, which is 125,000. Rounded, you would have got some decimals. 38.19. Normal mathematical rounding. 38. Check the number after decimal. If it is 4 or less than 4, round it down. It will become 38. Do the same thing for the other one also. So you get 37.83. I will have it in decimals. Then I will say number of contracts rounded. Normal rounding. 38. Done. So premium is going to be premium payable. Let me start with the minus sign because premium is a cost. So we are talking about 6 month expiry options, which are put options also. 6 month expiry put option 2.16, 2.63 cents per franc. 2.16, 0.0216 in dollars. In dollars. This is per franc. You know, one contract is 125,000 francs. So multiply by 125,000, you can get the premium cost for one contract. This figure is for one franc. A contract means this many francs. Multiply the total premium for one contract. Multiply by number of contracts. What is the number of contracts? Which is 38. 38 contracts. So that's going to be the premium in this case. In the other case, premium is 1.07. Premium is 2.63 cents. 2.63 cents. 0.0263. Multiply 125,000 contract size. So this is for one contract. You have 38 contracts. And the answer will come in dollars, because see, the if you look at this working, this was given dollar per franc, cent per franc, which I converted to dollar per franc, and then you multiply by franc. So per franc, franc cancels, the answer is in dollars. So this premium is going to be in dollars. But remember, this company is a Switzerland company and it doesn't have dollars. So when they start this option arrangement, to pay this premium, to enter into this option arrangement, they have to buy this many dollars to pay the option premium, to pay the option fees. So from where would they buy these dollars? From the cash market, spot market. Spot market rate, how much on spot rate when you are entering into this option arrangement? When are you entering into this option arrangement? Right now. Spot rate now is given. Current spot rate is 1.0635. So premium in Swiss francs is going to be, this many dollars divided by applicable rate. Same for the other one also. So this is in francs. That premium is calculated. Next thing, I have to calculate whether I am going to exercise each of these options or not. To decide whether I am going to exercise the options or not, spot rate is required. But in this question, they have not given me the spot rate after 4 months. So, I will write it here. Spot rate after 4 months. Merchant center unknown. This is not given to me. So, usually what do we do? Take the spot rate after 4 months, compare the exercise price. If spot rate is favorable, lapse this option. Don't exercise because spot is good. If spot rate is adverse, exercise price is better, then you say exercise the option because option is better. But here I can't do that. So, I'm going to make an assumption. I'm going to make an assumption here. What assumption? Assume both options are exercised. Okay, there is no other thing I can do. I can't just assume a spot rate also. So, I'm going to assume both options are exercised. Right? Assuming that, the cost is going to be. What this company has to do? Company has to give francs to the bank and get dollars from the bank. How many contracts they have? 38 contracts. So let me say amount to be paid to the bank or exchange or whatever in Swiss francs. See, for each contract you have to pay 125,000 francs. You have 38 contracts, so you have to pay this many francs to the bank. What bank would do, bank would convert them using this rate, exercise price, and give you the dollars, which is what is agreed. So, both case, amount of francs you are paying is same because it's 38 contracts, 125,000 size. How many dollars bank is going to give you? Amount to be received from the bank. Amount to be received from the bank. This is the amount you are giving. Bank applies a rate of $1.06 per franc. Multiply, bank gives you this many dollars. Same here again, you are giving this much. Bank will convert using this rate. Bank will give you this much dollars. So if you look at it closely, you wanted $5,060, $5,060,000. But in this case, the first option, you are getting only 5,035,000. So, 15,000 is amount under hedged. 5,060,000 is what you wanted. But what this option covers is only 5,035,000. 25,000 is under hedged amount. Whereas on the other one, you have an over hedged amount. 5,060,000 is required. But you have 5,082,500, which I can call overhedged amount. Overhedged. These are in dollars. Right. So what this amount underhedged means? You need 5,060,000. But bank gives you only $5,035,000, $25,000 shortage. What are you going to do? You can buy this $25,000 from spot market on that rate. But spot market rate is not given to me. So what am I going to do? I'm going to assume company has, because these calculations company can do it advance, because all these figures are known, exercise price is known, contract size is known. So company well in advance know that there is going to be a $25,000 underhedged amount. So, one thing they could have done, they could have gone for a forward contract to cover this 25,000. So, assuming under or over hedged amount was hedged using forward contracts. Why am I assuming though? First reason, I was not given spot rate. So, otherwise, it might be reasonable to assume, okay, you are converting these figures in spot rate and buying or selling it might be a reasonable assumption. But question doesn't give you the spot rate. So, second assumption I can do, assume it is covered by a forward contract. So this 25,000 would be you have to cover using a forward contract. What is the forward rate? Let me go back. 1.0677. I have already done working on that. 1.0677 forward contract. Yeah, 1.0677. So cost to the company is $25,000. They had to buy from the spot rate or buy using the forward rate. So it's a cost at this rate. Let me put it as minus because it is cost. I repeat again. You need $5,060,000. Option covered only $5,035,000. $25,000 you have to buy from forward contract. On the other hand, here you have an overhedged amount. When you need $5,060,000, you have got $5,082,500. $22,500 extra you have got, which also you can sell it back to the bank using forward contract, which will be an income to the company. So if you look at the summary of these options, when they are entering into the option arrangement, they paid this premium. Then to exercise this option, they had to pay this many francs. And then this is what they receive in dollars. So the net items, net cost to the company, you can calculate by considering these items. I missed the minus sign, let me correct the mistake. Right. So premium is this, amount you are paying to the bank is this to exercise the option, and then underhedged amount you are buying using the forward contract this much. Premium to exercise the option what you are paying to the bank, and any overhedged item you are selling through the forward contract, and this is the income. So net cost to the bank, net cost to the company, premium plus exercising plus any underhedged overhedged figure. So net cost to the company is going to be, if they are using the options, $4,869,000 or $4,846,000, depending on which option they are selecting. Right. Now what we have to do, we have to give a final conclusion. Let me summarize everything together for us to understand. You don't have to do this in the exam, just for us to understand. You had a forward contract, then you had a currency future, then you had currency option, which is 1.06. Then you had currency option 1.07. Let's see the outcomes. Forward contract, the outcome was, here it is, yeah. Forward contract outcome is net cost here. Futures outcome is here. Currency option 1.06 option is this. Other one is this. So first, when you have two options, let me rule out one of these options. See, I assumed interest rate moved adversely. Why? Then only I assume both options are exercised. If interest rate moved favorably, then options wouldn't have been exercised. Because, sorry, not interest rate, the exchange rate. The exchange rate at the spot market would have been better. So, assuming exchange rate is moving adversely, I assume both options are exercised. So, assuming both options are exercised, now when I compare the figures, this doesn't look good. That has higher cost than the other. So, 4,869,000 is completely an exclusion. We'll exclude that. Not worthy. Why not worthy? Relative to that, 1.07 is better. Okay. Now, comparing these three, other three, forward contract and futures have one similarity and option is different. Forward contract and future, what is the similarity? Both upside movement, downside movement of exchange rate, both will be restricted. What do I mean? If exchange rate moves adversely, you are safeguarded. If exchange rates move favorably, you can't get the benefit of that also. Forward contract is like that, futures is also like that. Option is other way around. Why option is other way around? If exchange rate is moving adversely, option will protect you. If interest exchange rate moves favorably, option wouldn't limit you enjoying the benefits. You can get the advantage when upside movement is happening. That is again, movements, exchange rate movements. Exchange rate movements, favorable, adverse. Sorry, favorable in one cell, adverse. When forward contract is used, favorable, you can't benefit from it. If it is adverse, you are safe. You are safeguarded. Same applies for currency futures also. When the movement is favorable, you can't benefit from it. Adverse safeguard. So that's what I said. Both upside movements, downward movements, both you cannot, you won't be exposed to. 100% is you are clipped at a rate. But when currency options are used, when adverse movement is happening, you are safeguarded. When favorable movement are happening, you can benefit from it. See the difference? You can benefit. So, let me compare these two first. Because these two are similar. Can't benefit, safeguard, safe. So, when I am comparing these two, compared to currency futures, forward is better. Forward is better because forward gives you lower cost. Because all other features, they are going to be same. So, exclude currency futures. Why? Forward contract and currency futures are almost similar in terms of risk management. Why? Upside risk is limited, downside risk is also limited. So, if they are similar, I will choose the best out of them. So, now you are left with forward or currency option. In other words, see, if you select forward or currency option, adverse movements, you are safeguarded anyway. Adverse movements safeguarded. This is where the difference is. Favorable movement, you can't benefit if it is forward contract. Favorable movement, you can benefit if it is currency option. This is what the difference it is going to be. So that the treasury management team in the company has to decide. If they think there are more chances of a favorable movement, if they think favorable movement is what is mostly possible to happen, they might go for an option because then they can get that benefit. If they think no adverse movement is what is mostly expected, then they might prefer a forward. So in my conclusion, I'm going to explain all this in the answer, final paragraph. What am I going to say? First, I'll compare these two options and say 1.06 is not worthy. It's more costly than the other option out. Forward and currency futures, because they are almost similar. Small differences can be there in between forward and futures in terms of transaction cost, which we have ignored. We have not considered that. So, ignoring forward and currency futures transaction cost, all other features are same, but currency futures seem to be expensive. Exclude that also. So,
So these two items are excluded. So it's going to be finally forward contract or currency option 1.07 exercise price the company has to choose. It's company's risk attitude to decide which one they would choose. That would be the final paragraph. I can't give a definite answer which is better. I'll just give final answer, a choice to the company, forward contract or currency option 1.07 could be better for them. Alright guys, I hope you would have understood this question's answer. Feel free to go through this. Feel free to get back to me if you have any doubts on this. I'm available on my WhatsApp number 0094-7791-48753. So if you have any doubts, if you have anything not clear, if you have any anything to discuss about this, feel free to contact me on WhatsApp on this number. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.